Joan, and this is my Rome. Welcome back to Joan's Rome. Today, we have just crossed the bridge of the Castel Sant'Angelo, which of course has the same name. We know that Sant'Angelo means holy angel. Now, the bridge was built, as was the castle, to be a mausoleum for Emperor Hadrian. Hadrian also built this bridge. He built it in the year 134. And at the time, it was the only bridge spanning across the Tiber. People used to get from one side of the river to the other, from, should we say, what today is Vatican City side to the central part of Rome. People used to get there by boats, by small boats. Now, the bridge today is called the Bridge of Angels, not only because of the mausoleum being called Sant'Angelo, but because there are 10 Bernini-designed statues of angels on this bridge. They're absolutely beautiful, and each angel is carrying something different related to the Passion of Christ. One angel has the crown of thorns, another has nails, another yet has the crucifix. Actually, there's two very beautiful statues, angels, done, sculpted by Bernini, which you can see today in the Church of Sant'Andrea delle Frate. He had sculpted them. They were going to be brought to the bridge. The Pope said to him, Gian Lorenzo, we cannot take these statues and put them on the bridge and have them be ruined by the elements and the passage of time. So those two beautiful statues you can see today in Sant'Andrea delle Frate. Now, when you crossed the bridge for the first Jubilee year, the Popes, so many people came from the center of Rome to go to Vatican City, the Popes actually put up a divider in the middle of the bridge so the people going to the Vatican City would be on the right, but it wasn't called Vatican City then. People coming back into the center of Rome would be on their right, on the other side of the bridge. A lot of businesses sprang up at the time of the first Jubilee, which was the year 1300. And a lot of them sprang up on the Rome side of the river, not the mausoleum side. And many of the streets took their name from those businesses. The object most sold at the time of the Jubilee was rosaries, coronari. And there's a street right behind us called Via dei Coronari, which today actually is the principal street in Rome for antique dealers. And by the way, in the past, making one's way through the vast throngs in Via dei Coronari and in other streets, but leading up to the bridge, could actually be somewhat hazardous to your health. In the holy year of 1450, some 200 pilgrims died in the crush to either get on or when they were on the bridge. They either died in the crush or they drowned in the Tiber River. Following that tragedy, Pope Nicholas V demolished the Roman triumphal arch that stood at the entrance to Ponte Sant'Angelo, pretty much where we're standing right now. In the late 15th century, Pope Sixtus IV encouraged the buildings of private homes and palaces along the street. I think you'll enjoy the peace, the beauty, and the history of this bridge. Imagine a bridge dating back to 134. So on your next trip to Rome, come see Castel Sant'Angelo, cross this beautiful bridge, and just linger for a moment and enjoy the history of Rome. For more insights into the daily life here in Rome, check out my daily blog, Joan's Rome, on EWTN.com.